You got one life. Are you going to be slaves or are you going to fight tyranny? Are you going to live up a little bit to your ancestors' standard or are you going to be way down below it? Yeah, we're taking fight. We're never going to give it up. We're standing tall. We're getting up there in the catapult. Ha ha.
Yeah, like, see, we're so cool.
Hey, man, you got to get fired up.
You do, man.
It's exciting fighting this tyranny.
You know, as
really being alive.
This is where the action is. Where else, what other thing can you talk about except about freedom, the protection of your country, the protection of your family, the stopping of these pirates? And then you make all these great new friends, and then it opens you up to all sorts of different concepts. And this is what's called the First Awakening, the awareness that the whole political and economic structure is totally manipulated and that there are pirates in control of the ship. And then, so we learn about ways to deal with this, and then is the spiritual aspect of this, because quite clearly, they've got more guns, they've got more money, they've got more soldiers. Now, we're
but
growing.
But they admit 90% of the fight is the mind. If we just simply refuse to get outside the box, and folks, you don't have to defeat the whole New World Order yourself in 10 seconds. It's deciding you're not with it. It's a spiritual decision.
Absolutely. It is a spiritual, psychological, mental decision. It is the law of intention. And if each one of us become aware of our own power and the fact that God does not make junk. God doesn't make junk. Yeshua, Jesus, talked about taking control. He said, you'll do greater miracles than I will. Be people of peace, but be strong. And be aware that through the law of intention, the law of creation, the law of allowance, and the law of harmony, is that we can create whatever type of world we want. Now, quite clearly, the wizards of the Illuminati, who are very, very advanced people, know about these universal laws. And they have been manipulating us through our food, through the chemtrails, through our education, through our media, to make us feel that we are victims, to make us feel that we are weak.
To make us feel weak.
Yes.
But if you know you're under attack, you can actually use that attack to make yourself even stronger.
Well, that's the first thing, is to get some power in your heart, to bring up that fire, but to also understand that this is going to be more like to win. And I'm here to win this thing,
jiu-jitsu.
Not to be a martyr. But, you know, if we go head-to-head with them right now, they're pretty tough. But it's like an Aikido match, and we're going to use their power, like just like Cassius Clay or Muhammad Ali did the rope-a-dope against Foreman. We let them use their power and for them to dissipate their power. 9/11, as horrible and as tragic as it was...
It was a failure for the enemy.
...was a total failure for them. And it allowed us, people like you and I and many others, to get the message out. And at first, we were derided. People would laugh at us.
But we were willing to commit. You know, I lost most of my affiliates when I did that. And we built them back up. Now that I'm bashing Obama, some affiliates are dropping.
Yeah.
I could care less. It's about the truth and never compromising and knowing that we'll reach even more down the road when it's proven that we were right. George Humphrey, we're going to do an interview here now after the show. I want to thank you for joining us. We had two state reps on today from New Hampshire. Very powerful. We had Bob Chapman on. I covered this amazing, is FEMA and DHS preparing for mass graves and martial law near Chicago? I covered that at the bottom of the next hour. And at the start, I got into how they're coming into everybody's houses in Austin and businesses and putting in remote control thermostats. You got to say no to them coming in your house and doing this, folks. They got the same thing in California. So that's coming up in the retransmission right now at oneplaceinfowars.com. See you back this Sunday with guests on the Chicago camps, 4 to 6 p.m. George, thank you.
Hey, brother.
That's it. Transmission starts now.